Okay, in case if anyone hasn't joined yet, please inform them to join as soon as possible. Sharing my screen with you, let's go to the simulation analysis first. Decision tree by using the adding of decision tree map was pending to be done, but that we'll do later on. I want to first complete the simulation analysis and then we'll go to that. Okay, now let me just give you the brief idea about the concept of simulation analysis. Simulation analysis is all about generating the random variables. The problem till now was that, see, if you take the decision tree analysis as well, there was something called probability that was given to us, right? Just give me 1 second. Okay. So there was something called probability that was given to us for the each and every cash flows. For the second year as well, the estimation of the probability was given to us. For the third year too, the estimation of the probability of each and every cash flow situation was given to us. Now here, identifying that at which cash flow you will have the which probability of occurrence is something which is the matter of challenge. Cannot be identified without putting too much of expertise. And there are great chances of us being wrong in this estimation of the probability, the exact probability. Simulation analysis is something where we'll be taking the random variables. Random means we'll just specify the range, and in that range, any of the cash inflows which may get occurred as per the normal distribution framework. So as per the normal distribution of the data, we'll just specify the range, and in that range, we'll take the random numbers of the cash inflows or any other variables which might get changed over a period of time. It can be the rate of return expectations too. I just want to get the 1000 iterations of the rate of return. Say from 14 to 16%, I want 1000 random variables. Similarly, my friend, the independent variables can be the cash inflow, it can be the cash outflow, it can be the life of the project. That means the number of years till which the project will remain. It can also be the rate of return expectations from the project. So any independent variable, we will be taking the range of it. And my friend, if you do not want to take the range as well, and if you want to make it extremely variable in nature, then also it's perfectly okay. But I think at least the range can be decided by us, you know, that it can move from 1 lakh to 5 lakhs. Now I am specifying a very great range. This kind of estimation is more realistic in nature, can be done as well, and more practicable too. But if I tell you that what is the probability of 1 lakh of cash inflow, the exact percentage of probability, you might get stuck over there. The estimation of the exact probability at the exact level of cash inflow might not be measurable, might not be very much precise. But random generation is something that can be done. Let's read the question, I guess. After that, you'll be able to understand it in a better way. Mrs. Melinda Gates wants to buy a vaccine production plant. Obviously, she will receive some money now from Mr. Bill Gates as a divorce alimony. You might have heard about this. Okay, the following are the details related to the plant. You know who is the richest woman in the world? The wife of Jeff Bezos. And she got the money from the divorce. Initial cash flow is $50 lakhs. I'm not saying that every woman would be following this track, but there are some. And I'm not saying that she do not have the right as well. She would be having the right, definitely. Why not? The rate of return required is 15%. Number of vaccines to be sold in a year, 2 lakhs. Price of each vaccine can be kept around $10. Life of the project is 5 years. Perform the simulation analysis of NPV by changing the random variables, namely number of vaccines and price of vaccines. by taking 1000 iterations. So 1000 times we'll be taking the random numbers of a price as well as the number of vaccines. Now, number of vaccines can move from 1.5 lakhs to 3 lakhs, and the price can move from 10 to 30. Now, that is a very rough estimate. I guess making a rough estimate will not be very much complicated for you. If you just specify the range in which the price of the vaccine which can move, or the number of vaccines which may get sold, I guess that can be done. That will be more precise as compared to the exact probability distribution at the exact level of number of vaccines and the exact level of price. That's what we were doing in the decision tree analysis till now. So we'll be taking the random numbers, and accordingly, we will be finding the probability of the NPVs at the different levels by using the normal distribution framework. Okay, let's move ahead. So my friends, first of all, I would be writing the, let me just decrease the size of it a bit. I'm deleting this column, which is not required as of now. Okay, so first of all the independent variables are given to us. We'll be writing it somewhere, and by taking the help of those independent variables, we'll be first of all preparing the NPV model, and then we'll be taking the 1000 iterations of the randomly generated numbers of price and number of vaccines, obviously in the specified range. So I'm starting write all the independent variables putting together. So I'm writing cash outflow. Now let me just tell you that I have taken the two variables right now. These variables can be any, my friends. It can also be three number of variables, it can be four number of variables, five, six, and so on and on. But the problem over here with the Excel is that the data table matrix function we follow, no, that will give us the combinations only up to two variables, because one you can put in a row, one you can put in a column. But if you take the five different variables, we'll be changing in a 1000 iterations, then I guess, my friends, it would be too many number of iterations you will get. And more number of iterations you will get, more and more number of combinations you will get, better and better your predictions would be. But I'm right now just changing the two variables, because the limitation I have right now is only up to the two variables, because I'll anyway use the function called data table to get the NPVs. So first of all, writing all these independent variables, cash flow 50. Now these are in dollars, obviously. The rate of return, the rate of return is going to be 15%, which is the expected rate from us. Now all these variables which are given to us right now, we'll be taking it as it is. Price of vaccine, right now they are quoting 10 USD. Then my friends, number of vaccines are 2 lakhs. I'm just writing 2 lakhs over there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And life of the project is 5. Just writing 5 years anyway, that will not be taken much into calculation, but still I'm writing it. Okay, now to find the NPV, what do I require? First of all, I require number of vaccines and the price of vaccines. Now let's assume that it will remain same in all this number of years. You can also have the model where in each year this number of vaccines which may get changed. That's entirely up to you. So I'm just right now assuming that my friends will be taking number of vaccines and price of vaccine. And in a year, whatever the amount we'll be getting as a cash inflow will remain same for all these 5 years. So we'll be finding the PVCI and the PVCO accordingly. And the one more thing I would be requiring to find the PVCI would be the cumulative discounting factor, right? So that I'll multiply with the projected cash inflow of the first year. So cash inflow of the first year multiplied with the cumulative discounting factor, so you get the total PVCI. So I'm just writing all the 5 years over here, 2, 3, 4, and 5 equal to 1 divided by 1 plus this 15% rate. My friend, that will remain constant. So I'm just putting F function 4 over there, closing the bracket, raised to, I'm putting the serial number as 1 over here because that cell will get changed, obviously, for all the observations from now onwards. Copying it and pasting it down to all 5 observations. So we have got the discounting factor. And the moment will change from 15% to 16%. It will get automatically changed, right? So I'm just right now taking 15% only. And here I'm putting the summation of it, SUM. And the summation is this much, 3.3521. So I'm writing it again over here, cumulative discounting factor equal to, I'm linking this cell, which is 3.35. Now, my friend, I can find the PVCI, PVCO, as well as the NPVs, right? PVCO is anyway given to us. PVCI will be rounded on now. So first of all, you may just write cash inflow per year. So equal to number of vaccines multiplied by the price of vaccine. Now, whatever the cash inflow you have got without taking the discounting, if you multiply that with the cumulative discounting factor, you get the PVCI, present value of cash inflows putting together all 5 years. So now I'm writing PVCI, and let me just mark all those cells which are independent. Let me highlight that in a yellow color so that we'll be able to understand in a better way whenever it would be required. So these are all my independent cells. Eyeliner kar dete hain. Yellow color ki lipstick bhi kar di. Let's move on. PVCI would be equal to this cash inflow per year multiplied by the cumulative discounting factor. So that comes around 67,04,310. PVCO is anyway 50 lakhs given to us. So we can straight away now find the NPV equal to PVCI minus PVCO. So I have got the NPV, which is 17,04,310. Now this is one model where each and every cell is interdependent on each other. Right now, I haven't taken too much of complications related to the capital budgeting problem because that we have already done it. For the simplification of the capital budgeting problem, I have just taken the very simple amounts and figures because our main task right now is to do the simulation of NPV rather than getting indulged into complications of the capital budgeting exercises. So taking it plain, it's very simple. NPV we have got. Now the major problem is that we want the 1000 iterations of number of vaccines to be sold and 1000 iterations of price, which can be somewhere around 10 to 30, in between 10 to 30. Now what is right now the price we have taken? 10, right? So my friend, just change the range of variables. let's put 15, 5 to 15. Because right now, anyway, 10 has been taken. No, so let's take the downward side price as well. So 5 to 15 is the range I'm taking for price. You may just change it. And number of vaccines, right now it's 2 lakhs. So I'm taking 1.5 to 3 lakhs. Fine, no worries. Okay, so we'll be just generating the random numbers now in a matrix. So you may decide which one you want to take in a row and which one you want to take in a column. So first of all, I'm taking for the column. And in column, I'll be taking... Hello guys, up to what point of time you couldn't hear me? I was actually explaining this to all. I had already created the table as well over here. So up to what point of time you could hear me? Can just someone give me an idea about it? I'm really sorry, I got disconnected even I was not aware about it. Is it audible?
Still NTV, sir. NTV.
Okay, now it's perfectly audible, no? Without any disturbance.
Yes, sir.
Can you just type it?
Yes, sir.
Haha, screen, I'm making it visible right now, but I got disconnected only. I was not even aware that I was disconnected. Anyway, let's move ahead. Share my screen again. Okay, up to NPV you could hear, right? After that, I had prepared this entire table and I had explained it as well. Anyway, let's move ahead. I'll do it again. I hope my voice is now perfectly audible without any disturbance. Just give me a confirmation, please. I guess so I can
yes,
move
sir.
Ahead.
Yes, sir.
Okay, sorry. This kind of thing happens, you know. Really sorry for the inconvenience. Main udhar hello hello chilla raha tha, malum nahi bachche hai nahi idhar. Okay, let's move ahead. So what I have done is I have created the random numbers of price of the vaccines, and I have just given the serial numbers of all of these observations, you know. So let me just use the magnifier again, and here I have taken the rand being fit between function. Let me do it only again so that you get it in a better way. Say from here I had started. So first of all, I had given the serial number up to 1000, and then in the very next column I had used the function called rand between. So taking the rand between, now rand between is using one algorithm by the MS Excel, so it is also taking this normal distribution into account, and accordingly it is generating the random numbers. We can also give the range for generation of these random numbers. The bottom will be the vaccine price at the bottom that we have decided in this case is 5, and the maximum can be 15, right? So I have 8 over there. Now I'm just copying this rand in between formula. I'm going to the cell of the serial number. I'm going to downside now by pressing control down arrow, coming back to it, and control shift up arrow. I'm pressing enter. So I have got the random numbers for all the prices of vaccines, and 1000 iterations are performed. I guess some voice is coming, no? Yes or no? Is some voice coming? Some disturbance? Or it's perfectly
no,
audible?
Sir.
Okay, fine. Okay, let's move ahead. And similarly, here also I am creating the random numbers, but the random numbers here would be varying because here I am taking the number of vaccines. Number of vaccines can move from 1.5 lakhs to 3 lakhs. So again, using the rand between function equal to rand between, and my bottom would be 1.5 lakhs. So I am just writing 1,50,000 there, comma. My top shall be 3 lakhs. So I'm writing 3 lakhs over there, closing the bracket, pressing enter. So I have got number of vaccines, which is very random in nature. I'm just copying it, and I'm going to the last cell of the serial number on right hand side by pressing control right arrow. Then I'm coming back to the second cell. Now I'm pressing control shift down arrow, left hand side arrow, sorry. So that my active data cell range is selected up to the last cell on the left hand side. Now I'm pressing control V. So I have got the random numbers, my friends, of ENPV. Now what you can do is, now this random numbers, we have applied some formula. So you may just fix it now, you know. Otherwise, what will happen that if you will do any change in this Excel worksheet, this random numbers will keep on getting changed. So let's fix it. So what I'll do is now, I'll again select this number of vaccines, putting together control C. And at that place only, I would be going to the paste special, and I'll be pasting only the values so that the formula will get removed and only the random numbers would be visible to me. That will get fixed, you know. So Alt HVS to go to the paste special, selecting this values option, pressing OK. So this random numbers that we have generated over here for number of vaccines to be solved will not get changed. Similarly, my friends, I select the price of the vaccine from the first to the last one. Control C. At the same place, I am doing the paste and using the paste special, just selecting the values, pressing OK. So those numbers are fixed now. And here in this cell, which is I11, my friend, I would be requiring the NPV, you know, so that I'll be able to prepare the data table entirely. Because that is the place, the intersection of the rows and columns, the intersection of the vertical line and the horizontal line is the place where we should place our formula. That is the only way we'll be getting the data table values of the various NPV calculations. Okay. So equal to, I'm just writing, you know, this P minus, or you would have linked this NPV cell as well. Then also it would have been perfectly fine. But let me just use the formula only. PVCI minus PVCO, which is 50 lakhs. So pressing enter, I have got the NPV here as well. 17,04,310. Now you people are aware about preparing the data table, you know, by taking these two variables into the matrix. I'm selecting it entirely. So control shift right arrow. Now let me first just confirm with all of you that are you all there with me till now or what? Yahan tak har koi mere saath hai?
Obviously, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Good. You will get the different numbers of NPVs. Huh? Do not get worried over here, because in everyone's PC, the random numbers would be generated differently. So my answers would be different and your answers would also be different. Let me just have the confirmation from all of us that you are there with me. If you are stuck anywhere, let me know. So I'll be waiting for you for 2 minutes further. Okay. So the downside as well up to 1000 and the upside as well up to 1000. We have generated the random numbers. Fine, let's move ahead. Once this NPV has been taken, no, then I need to select this entire table. But if I'll be selecting it by mouse click, it would be hadoo, dheere 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 sham ho jayegi. Hame sham nahi karni hai. What I'm doing is control shift right arrow, control shift down arrow. So this table is entirely selected. Now I can go to the data. In data, I can go to the what if analysis. Then I can go to the data table. Now row input cell is something which is getting changed in a row horizontally. Can someone tell me what is getting changed in a row? Would anyone like to say something? Please unmute yourself because I am not able to see the chat box. What is being changed? Number of vaccines, no? Yes or no? Okay, let's click on this button and select the independent cell where we have written the number of vaccines, which is 2 lakhs in my case. So pressing enter. Similarly, I'll select the column input cell, and the column input cell is the price of the vaccine, which is 10. So independent cell where 10 has been written, I'm selecting that, pressing enter. I'm pressing OK. It will take some time because there are too many numbers. Let's take its time. Okay. So my friends, we have got the NPVs at the random numbers over here. And here as well, let me just highlight it so that you will be able to get it that what these numbers are, you know. So all the cells which I'm selecting right now are the number of vaccines which may get sold, you know. So from the first to the last one, control shift down arrow, and I'm giving some color to it. तो मालूम पड़े कि ये एनपीवी नहीं है, ये कुछ और है. एंड सिमिलरली द प्राइस एज वेल आई एम सिलेक्टिंग फ्रॉम 7 टू द लास्ट वन. आई एम ऑल्सो गिविंग द कलर टू इट. तो मालूम पड़े कि ये एनपीवी सिमुलेशन में नहीं है. सो दिस आर द वेरियस स्टिम्युलेटेड एनपीवीज एट द डिफरेंट लेवल्स, यू नो. माय एक्सेल इज हैंग्ड. Let's wait for say 1 second. Excel would be like, itna kaam karwaoge, vasool kar liya pura humse. Okay, chalo kaam. Yahan tak har koi mere saath hai? Is everyone there with me till now? Have we created the simulated NPVs with the 1000 multiplied by 1000? So these are the number of combinations you have taken. So now that is pretty fair amount of number of observations to apply the normal distribution networks and the framework. Sorry. From Purvit, I have received yes. Others, I'm waiting for your response.
Yes. Yes.
Mr. Meet yes, has sir. Done. Ellie has done as well. Good. Jalpa too. Pooja, if you are stuck anywhere, please let me know. Okay. Now, let me just give you the brief idea about the normal distribution and its probabilities. So, let me just tell it to you in a very layman kinda language. You people would be obviously aware about it. This is how the distribution looks like, the standard normal distribution. Now, this is applicable to the various other things of the nature as well, no? And whenever any variable is randomly generated, we assume that it is standard, it is normally distributed. So how the probabilities are roughly varying, let me just tell it to you. Here we have the mean value. We can also call it a zero as far as the z-table score is concerned. Z-table gives you the exact probability for this normal distribution, you know. And on the right hand side, we would be having the one standard deviation, 1 SD. So that's basically 1 SD away from the mean value. So whatever the standard deviation you have got for all these randomly generated numbers of the NPV, within the one standard deviation, there is approximately 34% of the area covered. So I can tell you that 34% of the all the NPVs that we have generated till now will be within one standard deviation from the mean on a positive side. Similarly, on a negative side, there is around 34%. So somewhere around 68% of the cumulative probability you have, which will be varying one standard deviation on left hand side and one standard deviation on the right hand side. Then the 2 SD here this area would be somewhere around 13% of all the probabilities. This area is again somewhere around 13% of all the probabilities. This is the rough estimate, just for your simple understanding. And this one is 2SD here. Rough means it is quite quite near to the exact estimates. You may again check it in the Z table scores as well. So 13 plus 13, 34 plus 34. So in this area, my friend, somewhere around, let me just change the color of this. So in this area, somewhere around 13 plus 13 plus 34 plus 34. So that means 64, 68 plus 26. So 94% of the probabilities, or I may say the values, will be somewhere in between the 2SD away from the mean on a negative side as well as on a positive side. So what I'll do is, I'll just find the mean value of the NPV first. Then we'll find the standard deviation of the NPVs, of all the NPVs we have taken together, you know. Then, my friends, we will add one standard deviation into mean and we'll reduce one standard deviation from the mean. So whatever the range of NPV will get, there would be 68% of the probabilities that my NPVs would be falling within one standard deviation from the mean on negative side as well as on a positive side. And if I do it for two standard deviations, I would be quite sure about 94% of the probabilities. Why I'm doing is that when I would be having the random numbers, I do not know that in which range my what exactly would be the random number that would get generated. You know, I'm just clear about the range that my number of vaccines would be somewhere from 1.5 lakhs to 3 lakhs. And my price of the vaccine would be somewhere from 5 to 15. This is just a range which I have specified. I'm not quite sure about what will be the exact price. But if I would be sure about the probability, say within one standard deviation on negative side, on a one standard deviation on a positive side, this range is coming positive for the NPV. I'm quite sure that 68% of the probabilities are there that my NPV would be falling in this range only. So that is quite a good amount of estimate, quite a good amount of assurance we have related to the NPV simulation, you know. I hope you are getting my point. So you just go to the Z table. If you couldn't understand it, I'm just again explaining this further to you. As per the standard normal distribution, we assume that 34% of the probability, and it has been proven as well on the standard in the normally distributed data, 34% of the probability is there in, on one standard deviation on a positive side. Here as well, 34. So somewhere around 68% of the probabilities of the occurrences, obviously, will be falling within one standard deviation only, from negative to positive. And if I take it up to two standard deviation, and if that range is also positive, that means I would be quite sure that I'll not be making the loss now. Whatever the random numbers which may get generated in my range, you know. So let's go over there. And number two, what is the existing condition and the probability of the existing condition? That also we'll find. So existing condition, we are getting the NPV of somewhere around 17,04,000. So what's the probability of occurrence of this 17,04,000 from all the observations we have taken together? That is also something which matters most to us, no? So we'll find the probability of this as well. Let's move ahead. Is everyone clear till the time?
Yes, sir.
Good. You people are aware about it, right? You are there into this fourth semester, so I'm not stretching much into the normal distribution. So my next task is now to find the mean value, which is the average value of NPV. And then I'll find the standard deviation of the NPV so that I'll come to know about the range in which my NPVs would be falling and their approximate probabilities. Okay. So in a one column, in a one cell, sorry, here I'm writing the average NPV. So my friend, whatever the values you have got for all the stimulated NPVs, no, you will find the average of it. So average, opening the bracket, and I'm selecting all the NPVs that we have formed from the data table. So selecting all, right hand side and downside, closing the bracket, pressing enter. So my average NPV is coming somewhere around 25,88,355. I'm also finding the standard deviation now. So equal to, let's assume that we are finding it for the sample. So we are not finding it for the entire population. So that accordingly, the standard deviation figure would be slightly different, because when we find it for the sample, we put n minus 1 in the denominator to find the standard deviation, right? And for the entire population, if we do, we put n as the denominator, number of observations. So SPD EV is the formula to find the standard deviation. And STD EV I am taking for sample. STD EV dot S is for sample. STD EV dot P is for the entire population. So let's assume that this is the sample we have got out of the total population. And I'm selecting again all the NPVs, the range of it that we have got here. Closing the bracket, pressing enter. The standard deviation we have got is 28,79,136. You can also find, you know, the maximum loss and the maximum profit. So maximum NPV and the least NPV can also be found along with that. So maximum NPV equal to max function, opening the bracket and selecting all the NPVs again. Closing the bracket, pressing enter. So maximum is somewhere around 1 crore actually. Let me just convert it into a comma format so that you get it in a better way. Yes. So maximum NPV is somewhere around 1 crore and minimum NPV would be obviously min function we will be using here. So taking from the first to the last one, selecting the data entirely again, and minimum NPV is coming in minus 24,78,961. And this is the actual NPV we have got. You know, I'm just writing the name actual NPV. Or I may say the NPV at the existing situation. I'm just giving the borders to it. Okay. So friend, you will find the range of NPV now. So 1 SD at positive side and 1 SD at negative side. So what I'm doing is I'm just reducing and adding the standard deviation in my mean value, because 0 has been considered as the mean value, right? So what is the average? I have got 25 plus I'm adding the SD on the 25. So that comes somewhere around 54,61,532.42. And then I'm pressing equal to, then from average, I'm reducing the SD. So I have got the 1 SD on a negative side. So whatever the mean value of the NPV I have got, I have found the range of 1 SD, you know. So again, in that normally distributed data, I can tell it to you like this, that here is my Z score, which is the 0. So here I have got the 1SD and 0 is the mean value, right? Here I have got the 2SD. Here I have got the 1SD on a negative side. Here I have got the 2SD on negative side. So my friend, I have found all the probability range between 1SD at negative side and 1SD at positive side. So let me just change the color of it again. So this is the area for which we have found the range. And what is this area? This area somewhere constitutes around 68% of the total probabilities. So I can again interpret it like this way, that there is a 68% probability that my NPV would be ranging from -284,822 to +54,61,532. We also use this normal distribution framework for the portfolio performance, you know. So when we try to get the portfolio returns and the risk analysis, we use this concept over there too. So here in this case of NPV as well, we are using this concept. Have you got this exact interpretation of it? So what's the probability of this range? The probability of this range is 68%. So out of all the NPVs that you have simulated, that means randomly generated, there is 68% of the chance that my NPV would be falling in this range. I can ask you one more question like this now. Now, what is the chance that my NPV will remain positive? The cumulative probability that my NPV will remain positive. That can be a one question. What is the exact probability of the existing situation? You know, the existing situation is the NPV of 17 lakhs. So I guess these questions will be explored further by us in the next session. That would be the end of simulation from our side. But you have got it for 1SD. Let me again do it for 2SDs as well, so that we'll be quite sure about the range and the probability of the range will further be increased. So I'm again copying this two. Instead of 1SD, I'm taking the 2SD at positive side and 2SD at negative side. So what I'm doing equal to average minus 2 multiplied by the standard deviation. Not minus, in the first case it would be plus, sorry. And equal to average minus 2 multiplied by the SD. Now this range gives me the probability of somewhere around 24.78 and negative side it is coming somewhere around, anyway, now actual minimum you have got, no, that is slightly higher than the 2SD side. So we may check that in the 2SD only all these NPVs are coming. But still, if I want to just use this normal distribution framework, I can say that this is the range and I can be rest assured for 94% of the chance. Because if you add 13 plus 13 into 68 up to 2SD, it becomes 94, right? So in 94% of the observations we have taken till now, we may assume that the NPV would be falling in this range. So I hope you are crystal clear with the interpretation as of now. Now we have generated only the 1000 simulations of it. You can take 2000, 3000, 4000. So possibly more and more iterations you take, better and better prediction you will get. So if you just want to get the exact standard deviation and the exact average, it is my humble submission that you take more numbers, you know, because practically you may take 10,000s as well and 10,000s at the downside too. So better and better you will be getting. May I have the confirmation from the students that you have got this now, every one of you? Till now, is everyone absolutely clear about the interpretation side? So how realistic and practical this MPV simulation can be, it's perfectly known to every one of you now. The next lecture, we'll see that what is the exact probability of the existing condition. If we assume that this will be the existing condition, you know, that will occur, then what's the chance of this probability? So we'll find it by using the Z-score, Z-table in the next session. Okay, if you have any queries or question, you can just let me know, else I'm assuming that you are crystal clear with this. Please put your enrollment number as a mark of your attendance. That's it from my side. Bye-bye, take care. Sayonara, enjoy the rest of the day. See you all in the next session. Bye-bye, take care.